We've got 10 minutes.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Let's start this presentation with an introduction of our research question itself. How did Data Sentinel evolve with the introduction of digital media? To begin with, today we are moving in a digitalized world, and with the increasing use of digital media, as well as the increase in people using smartphones, Data Sentinel did have a need to evolve, and this is why we introduced digital media in their work. Then, the question to be put is very simple. How is Data Sentinel managing to carry on with its work, and how effectively did the digital media trend help them to move forward? We've come up with this research because we believe that Data Sentinel did things that are worth doing. Then, we came up with a research methodology among the many research methodologies that were available, and we chose interviews to work with Data Sentinel about this presentation. We chose interviews because these provide a first way to get information from the client. As well, we have considered real time availability, and for one reason, we will keep the interviewees anonymous. Why we've chosen the interview as a methodology for us to use was very simple. In 2011, in their book, Ferras, Block, and Seal mentioned that interviews provide a pathway for complex questions to be put in simple terms so that people can easily understand them. Moreover, Bryman in 2016 stated that interview is a way that attracts people to participate in what we want to do. But first, before we get to the details, it is important to have a brief overview of what Data Sentinel is all about. First, what will happen next is that my colleagues will present Data Sentinel as a group, and then the findings will be further elaborated.
Founded in 1963, Data Sentinel is the first development motion and one of the most published human motion to date. The group consists of its own digital press agency, a radio broadcast in the name of LSL Radio, and a printing press known as Caractère, among others. Last but not least, the publishing of specialized magazines and newsletters such as La Case and Essentiel, among others, consists of the pillars that keep the group running. Let's now bring to light the findings of our research. After conducting the interviews, we found that before Data Sentinel implemented digital media in its work, they were relying mainly on revenue from print media and advertising. All in all, the groups owned 3 papers which are released daily, 8 papers released weekly, and 19 magazines which are released monthly. All, they have 700 points of sales. About 5 years ago though, they entered the digital world and now release news instantly. Information are now available through Facebook and Twitter, and as well as on the 12 websites which are owned by the group. With L'Express alone, boasting around 3.7 million views monthly. Moreover, from a research on Alexa.com, a provider of article insight, we have found that L'Express is positioned third in Mauritius. Third may not be the very best, but let me tell you that Google is at the 5th position. Does it mean that Mauritian read more from L'Express than you, than Google? Even more, their competitors are ranked 7th and 9th position, being WFM Radio and DC Media, respectively. Now my friend Rebecca will elaborate more on the findings with a few
Because new supply line are readily accessible and free to all, L'Association could not get any revenue from it. So it has found other ways in order to still earn money while using those channels. For example, they monetize the newspaper niche online by linking their posts to express the value, or use the read more feature whereby the reader gets access to the whole article after answering a survey. Furthermore, they also use their newsletter whereby they link their production to their client's website in order to earn a certain amount of money. The fact is that today, La Sentinelle does no longer rely on the traditional advertising method in order to earn money. But they now focus on getting the collaboration of their other partners in order to still earn money while using the new trends. Also, as reported by DCBN, a Mauritian-based market and social research company, the readership of their daily printed newspapers, that is Express, has dropped from 70 to 62% due to the use of digital media. Moreover, now coming on to the employment at La Sentinelle, the use of digital media has enabled the creation of new job opportunities, including videographers, and also the creation of a new department that is specialized in the publication of business only. As for the other departments, the number of employees more or less remain the same. Last but not least, what is the future of the group as a whole, now with the introduction of digital media?
A very simple summary of everything that has been mentioned until now is as follows. Well, in an initial focus based on print media today, the company is concentrating on its efforts over digital media. Why? Global researchers from the likes of Westnet in 2015 have proven that today information travels fastest via the digital world. Since the digitalization of its work in 1995, La Sentinelle is still improving their methods of delivering information to its audiences. With the competition over digital media that is turning out to be a trend, slowly but surely, the diversity of information available will be much better, in the years to come. This is exactly why La Sentinelle has started relying on sponsored ads on Facebook, as well as a maximum of advertising opportunities, so that they can face the competition. However, it is believed that in Mauritius, print news will never cease to exist because there will always be a readership for it. Even if the way we consume information is changing over time, online news is consumed mainly through by people of the age 18 to 34. All in all, this is basically how La Sentinelle is expected to look in the future. Thank you for your kind attention. We are now open to your questions.
Excellent stuff, that was brilliant. Any questions from... They're still terrified, so I'll be able to ask some questions. It was excellent. I could see you speaking to people because you got a very good overview of the shifting what scholars call media system in Mauritius. There's some very, very interesting information on the kind of changing forms of revenue gathering that they use. That's very, very good, excellent. The only point I'd raise is the last thing that you mentioned when they said that print is always going to be prevalent in Mauritius. Was that told to you by someone at the centre?
By the manager.
By the manager. The manager's being a bit optimistic. Because I mean, you mentioned, you know, only 18 to 30 somethings will consume news online, but those 18 to 30 somethings will continue to own smartphones as Mauritius ages, and everyone who grows. So what's happened in other countries is that there's been a steady decline in printing. You're already seeing that here with the drop between 70 and 62. It will continue to decline for the simple reason that it's cheaper to run material online, and it's more effective and more efficient to advertise online because you can use metrics to determine exactly how many people are consuming the ads. So a lot of scholars argue that actually it's inevitable. There will be a point where it's quicker to have the news on your smartphone. But apart from that, it was excellent. And of course, if they say that, it's interesting that they'd say that. I don't agree with it, but very, 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 very good. Excellent stuff, guys. Thanks a lot. Okay, move on to the